All right, Shalom Rastafari. Greetings. Ine Rasia Dinos Tefari Neng. I am Wendem Yadon of the Lion Jew Society of Imperial Majesty, and we're reporting for the LOJ Society. Okay, so in the special report right here, the first thing we want to deal with is just to clarify. You see a lot of vids out there where they talk about this one is the Antichrist, that one is the Antichrist, and they probably say the same thing about us because there's a lot of false, you know, there's a lot of false teachings out there. And people have been in this falsehood for so long. And there's a whole counterfeit. There's a counterfeit Christianity already out there in the world. And it's been out there for some hundreds of years now. There ain't nothing new. Folks are saying Obama's the Antichrist and saying Bush is the Antichrist and this leader and that person who's in that movement or whatever. And they might be Antichrist. That's with an S, plural, right? But when we speak about the Antichrist according to scriptures, it's very important that we put the right historical timeline because there's a lot of false so-called prophecies out there, but most of y'all probably don't even know it because they use a new word, right? And the word is eschatology, right? Some of you might have heard about something called the great disappointment. I don't know if you've heard about the great disappointment. I think History Channel did something on this, on prophecies and different ones claiming to be prophets or inspired, the whole Nostradamus kind of thing. But if you do a little bit of research on it, you'll find that there's been, for the past couple of hundred years, in this Gentile world, under the Gentile world dominion, or under the so-called Europeans, you understand, under the Anglo-Europeans, the rise of the Gentiles. And that's prophecy right there. That is squarely prophecy. But a lot of the Christian preachers, especially the European Christian preachers, are those who've been inspired by the Anglo-Protestantism, right? The protesting against, really squarely against the black Madonna. Therefore, if Madonna, the mother of our Lord and Savior, is black, that means that Jesus must be black. But they had other issues too, talking about the Protestant Reformation, such as the inability to read the Bible only if the Pope, the Papal Rome, Greco-Roman, which is the bastion of this mystery Babylon. Even the Vatican, in their own writings, they admit this. But let's just deal with, first of all, the Antichrist, or the man of perdition, right? The man of perdition. Many are saying that's Obama, because Obama is about to, the United Nations and so forth and so on. There's a lot of different groups out there, right? And we don't have ability in this particular, or we don't have the time, rather, in this particular vid to go into it in detail. But what we want to do is deal with some of the fundamental basics. And we want to give you the image, right? The primary, or one of the primary images of the Antichrist. So you will know who the Antichrist, that man of perdition spoken of in Thessalonians, really is. Now, this is going to offend a lot of folks because a lot of them believe in this, even though if they were to study it, they'll recognize that everything that we're saying about it, all the background information, is basically true. Now, this is the image of the Antichrist, or the man of perdition. All right, now, along with the image, and Corinthians tells us this. Corinthians says that they will have another Jesus, right, another gospel, right, and another spirit. And he said that, and if they come to you with this, you would gladly put up with it. And many folks, ironically, still gladly put up with it, even though if we were to judge a tree by its fruit, and we have over 400 plus years of this, because it says that even after the 400 year, right, that the iniquity of the Amorites is not yet full. So who are the Amorites? How come we don't hear about the Amorites? Who are they? Oh, they're just the Canaanites. But then there's a whole falseness about the Canaanites. They have a lot of black people in the state of Israel and Palestine who are being preyed upon. Yehovah's are in a very difficult situation, and they're going around in this video saying, I'm a Canaanite, so forth and so on. No, those people that you call the Palestinians really are the remnant of the Canaanites in that particular land. Were they black? Well, wasn't everyone? If we were to study even what true science, not that evolution religion, we're talking about true science tells us. So right away, let's get into the image. Here's the image, right? Here's the image. Some of you already know this already. Here's the image of the Antichrist, right? Here's the image. There's a couple of images which are based on this image. Find out who this was. Find out who that is right there. You see the date? 1492. Add 400 years to it. What do you have? 1892. What occurred in 1892? Well, Revelation was fulfilled, the birth of that man-child. Who is that man-child? That man-child is Lij Teferi. All right, let's show you this right here. This is the man-child, right? The birth of the man-child, right? There you go right there. The birth of the man-child, Lij Teferi, right? Lij Teferi, 1892. Interesting, 400 years. Now, where was that? In a place called Ethiopia. Does the Bible, right? Does the Bible, even in its translation, does it have anything to say about Ethiopia? Well, actually, it has a lot to say. If we would look at the fullness from a non-Gentile or Eurocentric perspective, because it's like when Christ or Yeshua, HaMashiach, some people say that Jesus didn't exist. So when we talk about Jesus, some folks say, oh, you say a lot about Jesus. I'm surprised at that because everybody knows Jesus didn't exist. This is your Jesus that never existed as Yeshua HaMashiach. This is your non-existent Jesus. All right, this is your non-existent Jesus. Very clear who this is. This is Caesar Borgias. Remember Caesar Borgias? Remember the Israelites? They said that we have no king but Caesar. Shows that the Almighty has a sense of humor too. So gave the people exactly what they want. And you have black folks today still that hold to this image, even though that the 58 plus curses written in the book, right? Are, and every day they go, you know, every Sunday at least, they go to church and they have the Bible in the house and the evidence is right there of who they be. But yet they'll tell you if you ask them, what's your nationality? They'll say they are an African hyphenated American. You understand? So they belong to two continents. I mean, just go figure. You understand? That's the only people that don't know who they be. You understand what I'm saying? And that's the people, according to the scripture, that all those prophecies are fulfilled upon. Our lost but now found, a remnant is now found. So this is your Antichrist right here. Of course, a lot of, you know, you might flag this video, and already our site has been flagged for speaking the truth, right? And the truth is a what? The truth is an offense. It's an offense, but it's not a hatiyat. It's not a sin. You understand? It's not a, you notice what they don't do? They don't say, well, this is not Caesar Borgias. They don't say, well, his image was not used as the image for Jesus Christ. They don't say that, although this is the image that many people believe, you understand, the fruit of it is Antichrist. You see, the fruit. Let's look at the fruit. And we're not speaking about those Christians that in their spirituality, you understand, their exercising of what they read in the book, truly try to live the way Christ, the Word, the Spirit of truth has said to live. And so they're not so caught up on this, even though many of them probably still at one time or another believe that this was the image of Jesus Christ. You know what I'm saying? So that's the first thing that really needs to be dealt with, as you would say, squarely. You understand? That needs to be addressed. You understand? The Antichrist. The Antichrist, right, speaking singularly, not the Antichrist, right, but the Antichrist already has come. The Antichrist came before Christ in his kingly character, right? And there's Christ in his kingly character, that man-child, Kedemawi Haile Selassie, that son of man, on the biblical throne of David, right? On the biblical throne of David. And notice how they always try to put down all the evidence. Right? And why do they do this? It's not because the evidence of Ethiopia, the evidence of Haile Selassie, the evidence of Rastafari is much stronger, you understand, than all the evidence of so-called the European Jews and white people and all this European ism. And besides, We have been the victims. You know what I'm saying? We have been the victims of global white supremacy. But now, check it out. Because ones have turned their backs on this testimony, the whole world is at the point of being deceived. The whole world has been deceived. So what has happened to black folks, right, is happening to even white folks, even in America. It's only the bottom rail on top, Massa. You understand? The bottom rail is on top. So anyway, we want to just make a word on this because, well, you don't overstand the timeline. Right? When you don't understand the truth, when you're stuck in a certain, I made this mention before. I said that it's like if somebody comes to me and speaks, say, in Spanish, or better yet, suppose they come and speak in German, right? And they're saying a true thing in German, but I don't understand German. But now I'm so ignorant, I'm going to say that's false. But I don't understand German. I would have to, first of all, understand German or get a good translation, right, into the language I understand before I can really say whether it's true or false. But you got a lot of people dismissing all the evidence, the real roots of Rastafari, dismissing all the real evidence of Rastafari without going to the source, without checking the primary sources and the resources thereof. But this is very critical. This is very critical for the remnant. This is very critical for any true Christian to really understand. All right? And it's not like people say, oh, it's racist. It's racist. Can you imagine what black people in America and the Caribbean and all of the root race people have been through in the past 400 plus years? Some say 4,000. We'll hold on that for right now. But let's just deal with this time frame. If we can deal with this time frame and get a good foundation on it, then we can expand. You have to, first of all, deal with what you can know before you try to deal with what you don't know. You have to recognize the truth. Someone asked, they said, can you only come to the truth in the Bible or through the Bible? I mean, there's truth here, there, and everywhere. What do you mean by that? But if you can't accept the truth, that's right before your face. If you can't accept the evidence, right, because of a lack of grace, you see, and most folks, they lack that grace because they lack repentance. They are still thinking in the old paradigm. It's like in the Matrix movie where he said these people are so helplessly like inert. They're so plugged in to the Matrix, to Babylon, to spiritual Babylon and spiritual Egypt, that they would even fight and die, right, for the illusion and for the lie instead of accepting the truth of the matter. So this is your image, right? This is the image of the Antichrist. This is what the Hawadiyat or the apostles were seeking to warn. They said that it was already in the world. Remember what they said? It was already in the world. What was in the world? Well, in Rome, they were worshiping the Roman Caesars. Remember? The Caesars, the Caesars and the Caesarian family as gods, as sons of gods, and they were doing all sort of sacrifice to them. Remember what happened in Jerusalem when they had brought in the image of the idol? Do you remember the period of Maccabees? You know what I'm saying? But they did not merge that and whitewash the true Yeshua HaMoshiach. You understand? That would happen later on. And then finally, roughly around 1492, if you understand the history of this, especially with the black sheep, with the Beit Israel, with the black Hebrews, with the Ethiopian Hebrews, and even the Moors, because all of them are Hebrews. All of them are the children of Abraham. You know what I'm saying? We're talking about that, the 1492 to 15th century black Jews, right, or Hebrews. We're talking about the black Christians, right? And we're talking about the black Muslims or the Arabs, or they're more called the Moors, right? All of them are the children of Abraham. And when you really recognize what happened in that historical time frame and this counterfeit image and how global white supremacy, how that prophecy now, the times of the Gentile, would come into full fruition. All right, to full fruition. So this is the Antichrist that came before Christ. See, a lot of people telling you that, well, Antichrist is coming. Antichrist is coming. And this is just like the great disappointment, Because at its root, what's behind that is the Antichrist. So that folks become frustrated, just like the great disappointment I mentioned a little bit earlier. So they become frustrated, you understand, with the truth and say, oh man, I can't do the Bible, do Christianity, because it's counterfeit Christianity. You know what I'm saying? Counterfeit. It's not the real deal. That's why whenever we speak about the true image of Christ, what's the first thing that a lot of folks say? Oh, it doesn't matter what color he is, but yet they will put out more and more of this counterfeit image, and they don't want to even address it. Why can't they address it? Because they can't address it, right? They can't address it. And even if they address it and say, yes, this image was false, we have to look at all of the hurt, all the distortion that has gone on from that time to this present time, so we can once again realign ourselves with the true prophetic time frame of prophecy. And we need to do so. And people, you need to check this out for yourself. There's a wealth of information out there unlike any other time. You need to check it out for yourself. You need to find the truth for yourself. So Antichrist, right, came before Christ in his kingly character. Now, when we look at the prophetic, the biblical, I mean, from what the Bible says, not from what different eschatological interpretations of whitewashed Protestant European Christians, not saying that some of them are accurate. You understand? And we've been studying and finding a lot of accuracy, although very few of them could really put their finger on it. Even the Jehovah Witness said something. They said about 1914, Christ will come in the world invisibly. Now I see a lot of other Christian denominations trying to say the same thing, that he ruled from heaven, but ones could not see him. You understand? No, they did not want to see him. They did not want to behold him. You understand? They did not want to behold him. Instead, what happened? They fought against him. You know what I'm saying? And that also, those, the white robes, the martyrs, so forth and so on. We see all this prophecy being fulfilled. Okay, so let's stay tuned to part two. Now, we're not saying that His Majesty is Jesus. See, a lot of folks will be like, His Majesty is Jesus, right? Oh, you're saying His Majesty is Jesus. No, we're saying that His Imperial Majesty, Ketamawi Haile Selassie first, he fulfills the true biblical prophecy and the word that Yeshua HaMashiach spoke, if we look at it in its true context. But if we limit ourselves to the so-called Eurocentric perspective, and even many of us in the Afrocentric and the Black Hebrew Israelites, we've been limited, you understand, to just the data from the from either the Western Gentiles or the European convert, Khazarian Jews, or we've been limited because we've been turning our back from the real root of Rastafari, from our own Ethiopic and Hebrew language and the testimony of our people. We know they take it very seriously. We see what they did with the Beta Israel. You understand what they're doing with Africans. You understand how these people have a deep seed of racism against Black people. I mean, just go on the web, look up racism, Africans in Israel on the, I think it's on the YouTube.